Hi friends, welcome to Aishudiy. This is a necklace that I made. I taught on one of my jewelry making class. Actually, it came out pretty good. This was from an inspiration from a bracelet that I made. I think it's a Ulink bracelet. So I just had this in mind. I thought, why not do it? And I taught it in the jewelry making class. And it was nice. It was very pretty, so I just wanted to make a video out of it. Here I have used some fire polished beads. These are faceted 8mm beads in a chocolate brown color, and I have used silver wire and silver chain for this project. And for the project that I'm gonna show you guys, I am gonna make it in copper. So and I'm gonna use 6x4mm round dowels. So I have already made some Ulinks. I'll let you guys know how to make these, but these are the beads that I use. You can use any beads you want, as long as it's round or it's a round dowel, that's fine. Even if it is a bicone, it is fine. But to make the Ulink, it's better if you have a rounded shape, then it's easy to make the Ulink. Then for the earrings, you will need some ear wires, but that we will see in the next video. And for the necklace, we need some jump rings. I have here some couple of jump rings that we need to attach the chain with, and lobster claw clasp and a closed ring. And the clasp, you can add, you can take toggle or any other clasp that you have. Then we need some chain. I haven't decided whether I'm going to use a roller chain or just a cable chain. So I have these two chains in antique copper color, which I think I will decide later when down the project. So I used a roller chain, and it looks really nice for this project. But I still I'm still contemplating as to what to use. So as far as beads concerned, this is all we need. And then for tools, we need your nylon jaw pliers, needle nose pliers, wire cutters, and tweezer nose pliers. And that's about it. I think that's all you need. And then let's just add one more thing. Yes, it's the ruler. The ruler, we need it to measure the wire. So and that's and 18 gauge wire for this part, the Ulink part, because I want it to be stable and I want it to be strong. So I'm using 18 gauge wire for this particular length. And for the Ulinks, I'm using 20 gauge wire. So you can use anti-copper, silver, gold, whichever you have in hand. So 18 and 20 gauge wire we need. So these two gauges we need, and then the ruler. First, I will show you guys how to make the Ulink. So for the Ulink, I cut a longer piece, and I figured out this is good for my neck. So I have a short neck. So it depends upon how long you want your beads to sit around your neck. And this is my comfortable size, so this length also varies upon yours. So let's just measure this with a thread. So this is about, say, 8.5 inches. So 8.5 inches is this. And then we need for the loop, so I'll take about 10 inch of wire. Just to be on the safer side, we'll take 10 inches of wire, that is 18 gauge. So I don't have my nylon jaw pliers. My nylon jaw pliers broke, and one of the jaws actually flew by and I couldn't find it. So I'm just using a piece of cloth to straighten my wire. You can also straighten your wire with a piece of cloth, that's also totally fine. And I'm just not straightening it pretty well, I'm just keeping the U shape as such. And then I'm just going to measure about 10 inches. So I'm just measuring just like this. So this should be about 10 inches. So, and once again, it depends upon how long you want your beads to be. You can make it short or long, however you prefer. So this is again a versatile project. You can use any number of beads and it'll come out perfect. So we have our 18 gauge wire, so we don't need any more 18 gauge wire. Then what we are going to do is we are going to take our round nose pliers and make a loop at the end. So this loop, I want it to be a little bit bigger. I don't want it to be long, small, but I want you to make a complete loop. I don't want to straighten the loop, but I want the bead to completely come and touch my wire so that it's nice and strong. Just one side is enough. We are going to put the beads and then only we are going to close the other side. So that is ready. Now we will start making the U-links. So the for the U-links, you need the wire and your ruler, 20 gauge wire. So about, I think it is 3.5 centimeters. Yes. This one, this U-link that I made with 8 millimeter beads, I used 4 centimeter for sure for every link. And for this, because it's 6 by 4 millimeter roundel, it's a small, so I want only 3.5. That's good enough. So I'm just going to cut 3.5 inches of wire. I'm sure it's 3.1. Let me just make one and see. So you, as soon as you cut your wire, this is 3.5. okay, so as soon as you cut your wire, you put your bead inside, whichever bead you have. Just put it around the center. Just eyeball it. I'm eyeballing it. But if you want to measure, you can actually take your permanent marker and measure in the ruler and then mark the ends and then do the U. But all I do is I eyeball it and I keep it in the center and then I just bend the wire. I don't move the beads at all. I just bend the wire. As you can see, if you can see, the wire is a little bit longer here and a little bit shorter here. That's not what we want. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to open it up completely, because you can't straighten the wire with the beads. So I'll go ahead and straighten the wire. If you have a nylon jaw plier, that will be much more easier to straighten the wire. With this, it's going to be difficult, because it's a short wire. So actually it's 3 centimeters, that's all we need. 3.5 is a little bit longer, so I'm gonna measure myself about 3 centimeters right here, and I'm gonna flush cut the end actually and figure it out if it is exactly 3 or a little bit more. 3.2. Okay, 3.2 should be good enough for us. So take the bead and put it in the center and then kind of bend it. So when you're about to bend it completely, you will know which one is coming out correct or not. So if this one is a little bit short than this one, just move this and press it here. So just move this and move the bead here and press this side. Now you have a smoother view. All you need to do now is take your round nose pliers and then roll it into a loop. A small loop is good enough. Once you roll it completely, you take your pliers, put it inside, and then just twist it a little bit to make the loop straight, and then do the same here, roll it, and once you roll it, take your owner's place, put it inside, and then twist it back so that you have a straight loop, just a regular loop. That's all we are aiming for. And adjust your loop properly so that it sits straight, and you have your U-link. So this is how I make all the links. So you can actually put it inside the wire and see if it lays down properly. So depending upon how much wire you take, that will depend upon how big the U you have. So 3 centimeters is all you want, or 3.2 centimeter, whichever is appropriate for you guys. You can make those links. And once you make all the links, so I have here 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11 links. I have 11 links here, so that's all we need. So in this, because it's an 8 millimeter, I have 11 links here. So 12 links we will take, because this is a smaller size and we might need a little bit more, because this one is completely 8 millimeter, so it covers a long distance than this. So I shall move this necklace over here, and then let's just do one more link. So take it and roll it. I am making a small loop. If you want, if you are not comfortable making this small loop, you can actually make the big loop and cut a little bit more wire, like probably 3.5, and your loop can be bigger. Nothing wrong about it. If the loop is bigger, then it won't be seen anyways. It will be nestled inside or sandwiched between two beads, so it doesn't really show. So you can make your loop big or small. It totally depends upon how you are comfortable making it. So this is how you make the links. Once you make all the links, all you need to do is put the necklace together. So add a bead, add a link. Just add one end of the link, wait for it, add another bead inside, and then put the other link, just like that, and then push it all the way down. This is how you load the entire necklace. If it is a little bit big, there is space, all you need to do is just press it together. That's about it. Now add one bead, and then add the U-link. So there is, I call this part where it is open, the back, and the front part, I don't have the loop open. So I am paying attention to that too. So just add one link and add the bead. So it might be a little bit difficult to wiggle around, but you can do it. It's not that hard. Just put that in, and then, or what you can do is you can add your beads in here, just like that, and then put everything inside. Whichever way is easier for you, you can add the beads. One bead, and then your U-link with the bead. A bead and the U-link with the bead. Just pick up one, hold it in the center so all holes align, and then you can add it to the necklace. How cute is that? I thought that's very cute. I really liked it, and I want to make it in different colors and sizes. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the bell icon for notification. I do upload videos a couple of times a week. It comes around 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And I would like to hear from you guys. If you want to learn a particular project or so, just leave me in the comment below. I'll try my level best to do that. So this roundel beads, this wire, I bought it from parawire.com. You can order it online. They are online. And you can also get this from Amazon, the parawire. This is a good wire. And then the beads, I bought it from bbcraft.com. And they have this in a bunch. So they have two strands in one color, and they sell it in a bunch. And these are 6x4 millimeter roundels. This is also available in Amazon. You can buy Amazon in Amazon too. So Panda Hall is another company that sells this, and then Panda Hall products are available on Amazon and BB Craft. This is a fun project. You can change it. You don't have to. I mean, you can just, in another necklace, you can just add just the U-links and not the bead, just like this. Also, and not the beads. It's totally up to you. But I felt this one to be much more prettier. So I just added these inside too. It's easier if you hold the beads and the U-link together and then add it. So this length can be completely around your neck. You can do this as a choker, which I don't prefer. Actually, for myself, I feel uncomfortable with chokers, so I don't normally wear them. But for kids, I like to make them chokers, so for them it's cute and they don't mind it. You can also leave the links empty, and then you can probably stamp the bottom of the, I mean hammer the bottom of the link, and then add it to this thing. I have made a necklace like that. I'll make a video probably next time with that. So I have added all my links, but it is very short, as you can see. That's because even though I have 12 links, it's really, really short. And this one is bigger because I think these are 8 millimeter. Okay, this one is 6x4. So this is half the size. So I need quite a bit of the U-links. Let me show you guys a couple more times how to make the U-links. So that's just 3 centimeters. That's more than enough, I guess. So here you go. First, I want you to flush cut the end and then measure it, because when you don't flush cut, the links won't come out properly. I'll do a couple of them. So you flush cut the end. This is a flush part of the flush cutter, and this has a pointed end. If you cut this side, it will be a pointed one. So here I go, I flush cut the end, and then I keep this as my measurement, and then go ahead and cut this, and then flush cut the end. Keep this as a measurement. Take my cloth and run my cloth in the wire so that it straightens it out a little bit. Probably I need another, say, couple of them. So there we go. That's enough. I have 5 of them. Now I add my bead. Bring it in the middle. Hold it in between my index finger and my middle finger so that I have a grip on it. And then carefully bend it upwards. There we go. And then what we need to do is take our round nose pliers and then make the loop. Then go ahead and put your mandrel inside and twist it upwards, and then again close it. Do the same this side. Then you have your Ulink. The next one, put it in the middle. I find this to be much more stable for me to make the U. There we go. And once you're done with that, go ahead and make your loops. Press your Ulinks a little bit so that it comes straight. Take your pliers to adjust your loop and close it completely. I shall finish stringing, making all these things. And I'll come back.